Hello friends, in this video I will be helping you with the difference between spontaneous emission and stimulated emission. So let's start. So if we talk about the spontaneous emission, what happens is it is a natural spontaneous process. So this kind of emission happens naturally and it doesn't need external inducement or external photon to start it. But if we talk about the stimulated emission, it is not a natural process. So to initialize it or so to make it happen, we need to provide an external inducement or external photon to start it. Next thing, if we talk about the spontaneous emission, it does not require external photon as a stimulus to initialize the process. So it does not require anything which is artificial or which is external for starting the process. But if we talk about the stimulated emission, it requires external photon as a stimulus to start the process. So in the case of stimulated emission, an external stimulus is required. Next thing, if we talk about the spontaneous emission, the emitted photons move in all direction and are random. So the photons that we receive from the spontaneous emission, they move randomly in all direction. But if we talk about the stimulated emission, the emitted photons move in same direction, so they are polarized, okay, and also is highly directional. Next thing, if we talk about the radiation, then in the case of spontaneous emission, the radiation is less intense and is incoherent, or you can say inconsistent, okay. But if we talk about the stimulated emission, the radiation is highly intense, monochromatic and coherent, or you can say consistent. And if we talk about the spontaneous emission, photons are not in phase. There is no phase relationship between them. So between two photons, there is no relationship, or you can say no consistency, or you can say they are not having a constant phase difference between them. But if we talk about the stimulated emission, photons are in phase, that is, there is a phase relationship between them, or we can say there is a constant phase difference between them that exists. So this was all about the difference between spontaneous emission and stimulated emission. So if you like the video, please do hit the like button, don't miss subscribing, and thanks for watching.